yesterday and today and forever. The Church of Jesus Christ presents Pastor and Evangelist Pete Rowe.
Thank you, Jesus. All right, children, I want to welcome you back today, and we appreciate the Lord. And I've been speaking on something here that's very important for people to draw nigh to, because the more we understand the revelation of our Lord, then that means we can draw closer to Him, and especially when you learn about who He was and is to come. See, He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And if you remember, Paul said, I'll come under visions and revelations of the Lord. So these good men, they didn't only walk with Him, talk with Him, but He showed them the depths of Him, His glory. And of course, we'll none understand it all, but one thing's for certain. Paul said, I know in whom I believe. And he was persuaded. So today we're going to begin a little bit out of the book of Genesis, a little more on the greatness of His creation and why it's important for you to not only look unto Jesus as your comforter, as your helper, but He's the man that formed you. He put your brain, your eyes, your heart. So who's the best physician for you? I believe the one that made you knows everything about you. That's good. He knows you before you knew you. Remember, He told Jeremiah, I formed you before you was in your mama, or before you was in your mama's belly, I knew you. So Abraham, all of these good patriarchs, they walked with Him, they knew Him, but we know Him in a little deeper depths in these days, because He was manifest in the flesh, and He brung it deepest that's ever been given concerning the Creator. And that's why Jesus said, all things are delivered unto me and my Father. And no man knows who the Father is but the Son. And it takes the Son to reveal Him. So anyway, if you will, turn with me to the book of Genesis, chapter 1. And I want to show you that God did have a person as well as God was spirit. Now, a lot of people, they take John chapter 4 because the Bible did say God is a spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit. But if you read that again, it said God is a spirit. So He was a little more than just spirit. I want to show you He did have a divine person even at the time of creation. And that's what Adam was made like. That's what all human was made like, in His likeness. Now, listen first of all to the book of Genesis, chapter 1. And I don't expect people to learn it all overnight, but I'm going to tell you something. I've never fell in love with the Lord like I know I could until I started studying and learning about Him. And buddy, He become light to me. He shines in a dark place. There's nothing that you can't do or go anywhere that light won't be there with you. He'll shine for you, children. He'll protect us. He's a mighty Savior to us. But listen to the book of Genesis, chapter 1. And the reason that you need to know these things is because just about 90% or more of the world's been taught a little different than truth. See, they've got Jesus as a second person. I'm not throwing off, but truth's truth. And most people have been raised up to believe that, well, I thought there was three. See, but when you study it out, it don't come out like that. And the problem is, if we don't study, then we'll listen to the pastors and the preachers and so forth, and then we'll just do like Paul said, have an itch in ears, and we'll just heap us up a bunch of teachers. But you need to be fully persuaded within yourself. Because, children, I'm going to be honest with you. The name of Jesus Christ, as Peter preached it, was the name of the Father, as well as the Son and the Holy Ghost. And that's why Peter had to obey and talk to people and baptized in that name, because that's the way Jesus told them when He gave them the keys. But anyway, listen to Genesis 1 here, if you will, and verse 1. Now, notice it. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. See, I mean, you would have never known that if there hadn't have been a report about it here. Genesis. I guess the writer was Moses, but you've got Exodus and all these other books where God would appear before these prophets and speak to them. See, they were learning of him too. He spoke out of the burning bush to Moses, spoke out, of course, opened the mouth of a donkey and spoke. I mean, just various ways. But in the last days, Hebrews 1 said he spoke to us by his Son. So now you're looking unto not only the Son of God, but you're looking unto the author and the finisher. The author of creation, the finisher of creation in the earth, but also the author of your salvation and the author and finisher of your faith. So, Bible said in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the waters. That meant the earth was literally nothing. When Jesus was creating, he made it out of just speaking the word. That's all. See, Psalms 33 said, by the word of the Lord were the heavens made. Now watch this. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God. Now there's something you need to notice. And the Spirit of God moved over the face of the waters. And God said, let there be light, and there was light. Now, before God ever spoke, his Spirit would go over the earth, or over the waters rather. And then he spoke everything in existence. Read the whole book of Genesis chapter 1, and all down through there it would say, and God said, God said. But here's something you need to recognize in verse 26. That's the reason I've been teaching on the sonship of him. All right? In verse 26 of Genesis 1. And God said, now go back and read that whole chapter, because he just spoke everything in existence. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. Now listen to verse 27. And so God created man in his own image. Now, did you notice verse 26? God said, let us make man in our image. Well, verse 27 said, so God created man in what? His own image. So who was the us? That was God's Spirit and his person created man in his likeness. Remember, when the Spirit moved over the waters, God would speak. And when he said, let there be light, there was light. Then he started saying, let there be waters. There was your waters, the seas, and dry land. And he brought everything out of the waters, you know, called them by name. God said. So when he gets down after the beast, then he wanted man to be created. So you say, who was he talking to? Who was he talking to when the Spirit moved over the waters? That was the Word and the Spirit. See, God said, let there be light. Verse 26, when God said, let us make man, he wasn't talking to another one. He was talking to his own person there. I know it's hard. But Christ was the image of the invisible God, as I read you. So Christ was God's image that was made flesh. Hebrews 2:14 said, as much then as the children, that was Israel, are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same. And if you read Revelation chapter 1 and Acts 20, it's so much it goes with it. Acts 20:28, Bible said he purchased the church with his own blood. The Word was made flesh. Children, this is something we need to recognize. Jesus was right when he told Thomas in John 14, when you've seen me, you've seen the Father. He wasn't telling Philip that you see a lookalike. No. The reason he could say, when you've seen me, you've seen the Father, is because God was manifest, made flesh. And Christ was that image. And children, this is where the world's misconstrued it. And I'm going to be honest with you. You'll never understand this until you're willing to hear these men that wrote this book. See, let me show you something. When he said the Word was with God, that didn't mean it that God was to there. It just meant God had his person with him, the Word. And the Word was made flesh. See, that's why when Jesus was made flesh, he had hands and hair and a mouth and so forth. And here, when the Spirit of God moved over the waters, he spoke. So God was spirit and he was person there. By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the host of them by the breath of what? His mouth. You reckon you can have a mouth and not have a person? Come on. Stretch forth his hands. All through the Bible, God had a person. Remember there? I just read you in Isaiah 44, 24. Thus saith the Lord thy Redeemer, he that formed thee from the womb. I'm the Lord that maketh all things, that stretcheth forth the heavens alone and spread abroad the earth by myself. So you see, he had hands and he formed a crooked serpent. I mean, he did everything by his word and his spirit, children. And that's the mystery that God is bringing to his people. And it's going to be very important to know these things in the future, because children, God's bringing a bride out of this church system, getting his people ready. Because we're going to have to go out of here. And we can't go out of here being deceived and full of lies. We can't. We got to go out here believing the truth. And children, I'm just saying these things to let us know that we're coming into the closing times. And we need to give earnest heed to what we're hearing. Because there's a faith that God delivered to his people. And children, it was brought first by Jesus, see. And he told us to give the more earnest heed to what we hear, lest at any time we let it slip. So see, these are things that God's bringing and enlightened to his people. And I'm just telling us, children, that it's time we open up our Bible. Let's go right quick, if you will, to the book of 1 John, chapter 1. 1 John chapter 5 and verse 7. Now read this in your Bible. And let me tell you, there's some of these newer Bibles out here that don't have this scripture. You ever wonder why? Because Satan don't like the name of Jesus. But it don't matter what he don't like anyway. But listen here to verse 7 of 1 John chapter 5. For there are three that bear record in heaven. Now notice this. Three that bear record in heaven. The Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. Notice it didn't say Son, but yet that was a Son. The Father, the Word. So the Father was the Word and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. And there are three that bear witness in earth. What is it? The Spirit and the water and the blood. And these three, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, agree in one. So who is the one? That's Christ. Now, listen to me. The prophet asked the question, can two walk together except they be agreed? The answer is no. Well, then how in the world could Jesus and his Father walk together if they were separate? See, that's what people, God's bringing us to this knowledge of. Now, we want you to go with me right quick, and I want to show you something that really touched me years ago, and I'm telling you, it helps you through praying, bring you to where you can trust the Lord. And I mean, you can have confidence in him, because you're not looking to no ordinary fella. You don't have to have that imagination as Jesus being like that fella hanging on the wall. Long hair and brown eyes and a beard and whatever. But think of him as the Bible teaches him. He must be worshipped now in spirit. But John saw him on the Isle of Patmos in his form, in his person. And these are things, children, that God's bringing his people to the knowledge of. Now go with me to John chapter 17. Listen to this. And I'll begin at verse 1. These words spoke Jesus, lifted up his eyes to heaven, and said, Father, the hour is come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son may also glorify thee. Now think about it. as thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. And this is life eternal, that they may know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. Now hold on. You notice there's an and there in between true God and Jesus Christ. Well, does that and separate God and Christ? No, sir, it don't. See, you can use the word with, or the word and, or the word us. And it can work in separating something, or it can also bring together. For instance, if you're the mayor of the city, or the judge, or the president, you're on record. You were a senator, you were a congressman, you were this or that. All of that is records, see? And Jesus, on record, was Father, Word, and Holy Ghost. And if you'll read John 14, it was Jesus that said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. And you remember, these little disciples didn't understand it either. So they said, Lord, we don't even know where you're going. And he let them know he was the way. And he said, no man comes unto the Father but by me. And of course, Philip and Thomas wanted to question him. And they said, Lord, Philip said, Lord, show us the Father. And it sufficeth us. In John 14, listen to it. Let me just turn to it. John 14 and verse about, let's just start at verse 6. Read it in your Bible now. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. Now listen to what he said in verse 7. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also. See, he had to tell them and let them know. And from henceforth you know him and have seen him. Now, what were they wanting to know? Where are you going and who's your Father? Well, listen to this. Jesus said, if you'd have known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth you know him and have seen him. Who? Him and his Father. Well, let's get some proof. Philip said unto him, Lord, now come on, most of us, you were taught he was Lord, and that's good. Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Did you know David, in his writing in Psalms 103, wrote about this question here? And David said, know ye, Psalms 103, know ye that the Lord, he is God. And of course, God's a Father. Know ye the Lord, he is God. It's he that made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. And here Jesus said, I'm the good shepherd. So what was Philip saying? Verse 8, Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Jesus said unto him, have I been so long time with you, and yet is thou not knowing me, Philip? He that has seen me hath seen the Father. Come on. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Watch verse 10. Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? Now how can you separate that? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that what? Dwelleth in me. That's a spirit. He doeth the works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very works' sake. Because if you believe the works, it testified of him and who he was. Now, I'll run y'all over again. Go to the book of Malachi. Children, I'm just bringing us out of this mind-boggling world and trying to get us to understand truth, because if people can get together in the same unity and faith, you better believe God will show you things. He'll help our people. God don't want people divided. It's sad. And I don't mean to hurt, but it's the same way among the Jesus people. We've got divisions all over the place. One part of believing the church will be raptured before the tribulation, some during it. Of course, I'm one of them after the tribulation. So you see, there's divisions. We got them among baptism, just like the rest. Some believe baptized in the name of Lord Jesus, some Jesus, some Jesus Christ, some Lord Jesus Christ, and some whatever you want to. So what's right and what's wrong? We need Jesus personally and go His way, His word. And it don't matter how I teach or you teach, but what are we believing and what are we teaching? If Jesus said in Luke 24:44, that the words that I speak was written in the law, prophets, psalms, so forth concerning me. And he commanded them repentance and remission of sins be preached in his name. Well, he give you a starting place, beginning at Jerusalem in his name. So go to Jerusalem where it started at Pentecost, and that ought to be enough to start us. But now you've got so many divided, but it's not God's fault, children. He wants us together. Now, we're back on here to the question that Jesus, when they said Philip here in verse 8 of John 14, Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Now, people said, well, that meant he looked like the Father. Well, see, that's not the question. Philip didn't want to see the look-alike. He said, show us the Father, because Jesus told him, you don't come unto the Father but by me. Well, he wanted to know, well, where is he? Show him to us. Well, here's his answer. Jesus said unto him, have I been so long time with you, and yet hast thou not known me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Believe thou not that I'm in the Father in me. Now, when did the Father ever leave him? Only on the cross. Did he raise from the dead with all power? Yes, he did. And did he command them that teaching all nations of fullness in him? Yes, he did. Read Colossians chapter 2. Paul said, beware lest any man spoil you. See, he knew what would happen in 325. That big nice and cancel. Rome comes together and they preach one God but separate them into three persons. Children, listen to me. And most doctrines of our denominations today agree exactly with the Roman Catholic Church. In 325, somewhere through there, when they came together and they taught one God in three persons but co-equal, all same. See, that don't work with God. You can't do that. Because that'd be three separate gods. Well, let's find out if Jesus was just talking about himself or a lookalike. Now, go back to the book of Malachi. Turn with me to the book of Malachi. Chapter 2 here. Mark it down, Malachi chapter 2, verse 10. Listen to it personally from God. Have we not all one Father? That's a question. Hath not one God created us? Why do we deal treacherously, every man against his brother, by profaning the covenant of our fathers? Did he say here, have we not all one Father? Has not one God created us? Paul had to come to that revelation. He was very mad when he lived that Pharisee life before he got converted, because people were teaching Jesus. He held the clothes while they were stoning Stephen. And he went to the priest, which was still trying to rule in the law, and got letters from the high priest that if he found any on this line of teaching, to bring them down to Jerusalem to be punished. But thank God for that light. And you get it now through the gospel. That overshined him. And a voice come from heaven said, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? What did he ask him? Who are you, Lord? See? I'm persecuting somebody here, but who are you? What did he answer? I am Jesus whom thou persecutest. It's hard for thee to kick against the pricks. But if ever a man got his eyes open right there, I know it had to hurt him, because he said, Lord, what will you have me to do? Mm-hmm. Remember, he had letters from the high priest to put people in jail. And he held his voice while he was stoning them. Let me tell you something. He might have went a little further. But thank God for that light. And he said, Lord, what do you want me to do? And he told him, go to a street called Straight. And then there was a little man came to him by the name of Ananias and told him, said, Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, appeared unto thee, sent me to open your eyes, and said, why do you tarry? Arise, be baptized, calling on the name of the Lord. And you better believe he made one of the greatest Gentile Jesus name preachers you can find. And that's when he brought that question up, speaking of Christ, because there was persecution against him, persecution coming against the church by the Jews at that time, and Rome too. And the question Paul asked was, is he the God of the Jews only? Is he not also of the Gentiles? And his answer was yes. So that rock that they ate and drank of in the wilderness that led them with a cloud by day, fire by night, Paul said that rock was Christ. Jesus said, on this rock I'm building my church. That made him the same yesterday, today, and thank God forever. So children, it's time we open and study. Don't be afraid. You're not going to hurt yourself. A lot of people, if you really start seeking the Lord, might get aggravated. But when you make up your mind, you're going to go to the Bible and you're going to believe it. Don't ever separate yourself from the Word. Stay with the Word of God. And if God's going to bless, it's going to be these little believers today. The ones that's holding up His truth the best they can. And children, I know sometimes my teaching's a little over our head. But if you tape these things or maybe write them down, you can go over and over and over and read it and pray for understanding. Because I'm not pushing myself to know any more than anybody. But I do know who I believe today. And I do know, children, that if you'll obey His word, and if you're lost today, you read the book of Acts. Because I've told you before, there's a promise of the Holy Ghost to you, your children, and to all afar off, us Gentiles. And it's all in the name of Jesus Christ. Acts 2:38 will be the best step you'll ever make, children. And it fulfills Matthew 28:19, which I'll have to get in another time. But we do appreciate you. Now get on our website. We have some good articles. If you can, come out and be with us. And children, we love every one of you. And we're not trying to be offensive, but sometimes the word does offend. But we just want you to know we're running out of time. And we need to get back to the source, the Word of God, and believe these good men. So, Lord willing, I'll see you in our next program. Pray for us, member our families, and we'll see you, Lord willing, in our next program in Jesus' name. God bless you is our prayer. Amen. Thank God.
We would like to thank you for joining Brother Rowe and invite you to continue with him in outreach. Your prayers and support will be deeply appreciated. If God leads you to help in this ministry, please send your contributions to The Church of Jesus Christ, Post Office Box 283, Baxter, Kentucky 40806. And may God bless you.